Hello everyone, Mike Mixon from KeyboardAmerica.com and .co here in Lewis Beach, Delaware, and I hope you had a wonderful Thanksgiving. Today's song, Close to You, there will be a lot of lessons learned here on how to use your Genos and your Tyros. So I'm going to show you a few tricks that I do and some things that I do that you could try at home on a song that I'm not doing that you want to do. So it's going to be a very good teaching video as well. And of course, this is just a gorgeous song. And with the chord changes I've put in and the settings I've put in, I think you're going to really enjoy playing it. Karen Carpenter, in my opinion, was really the best singer on the planet, next to Bette Midler. There are a lot of great voices out there, but when you listen to Karen Carpenter, there's just something about her voice that's so pure that it's not approachable. I think excuse me, Bette Midler is also phenomenal, and I love doing her songs. I love a lot of other female artists as well, but they're really my favorite too. So let's take a look real quick at the music and give you a little advice on how to do your own settings on a song that you want to do. Okay, so we're using Easy Swing is the style, at least until I rename it to Close to You by changing OTS, and the tempo's at 100. We're at intro 2, variation A the first time through, variation C the second time through, and of course all the chord changes are there. Now, if you are not in the Book Bundle Club, you can email me at genosmike@hotmail.com and get my free chord chart. You'll just have to go back and forth on the music to my chord chart to get the proper inversions and fingering. So the fingering, it says F major 7, 5, 3, 2, 1 are the fingers, and F, A, C, E is the proper inversion and notes for this. This is in Bank 6, registration number 6, so I'll be sending you the user style in the email with the music and the new registration bank so that you can overwrite bank 6. And the chord changes are important in all these songs because the Easy Play music does not have all the right chords in there, so it's quite a process. There's also some grace notes that you're going to hear at the end of the song, and let me show you that. So you can see in red here the grace notes that I've put on, and of course all the instructions and the custom ending that I made grace notes at the bottom there, which is very important. I'll bring that up a little bit and you can see them there. Okay, let's look at the settings now. Now, I told you this was going to be a teaching video, so that's what I'm going to do. You see it says Close to You here. Because that's my new user style with the OTS settings in it. If I go back to preset and I go into Easy Listening and I go to page 2, I see that 70s duo pop. Now, by listening to the intros and the style, I could tell these were the Carpenters right in here, great for those songs. However, they weren't perfect for this song. So because the Carpenters are here, some of these other styles may be a Carpenters one, and that's where I found Easy Swing. So it's a little bit of prep work to find the correct style if you're doing a song that I'm not covering in class. Keep in mind that the user style's Close to You now because I renamed it once I changed OTS. And we're working in song Bank 6. So when I send you the file, download Close to You first, load it in your Genos, and then go to song Bank 6 and put it in number 6. Okay, so I found the Easy Swing style that goes with it very nicely, but I went out and listened to Karen's CD. and I listened to the band behind her. So what I did was I hit out exit here, and I'm going to go into my mixer, and I'm going to go to my style. Now, I did not do this, but I want to just show you something that you could have done. When I listened to the original beginning of this song, which this sounds perfect for, I'm going to play the intro real quick. Now, one thing that wasn't on the album were the strings that were in the background. So if I wanted to make it perfect, I could just turn the strings off there in my mixer on Style 1, redo that intro, but you know what, I liked the strings there even though they weren't on the original album, so I just kept them. But that's how you can edit things on your Genos, just by listening to the CD, listening to the style, intro, listening to the variations to see what's going on there. Now, as I exit out here, I am going to just press my registration number 6 to get back to close to you there. And I'll show you everything that's on in just a second. We're going to go to OTS number 1, and I just chose a concert grand there, CFX concert grand, and my volume is at 127. On number 2, I chose a CFX cocktail grand with a vibraphone. The cocktail grand is at 100, and the vibraphone is at 60. On OTS 3, it was flugelhorn, smooth brass, and mute swing horns. And it's 80 on the flugelhorn, 100 on the smooth brass, and 90 on the mute swing horns. On OTS 4, I went back to the CFX concert grand, vibraphone, and boys choir, Now, it is 100 on the cocktail grand, 60 on the vibraphone, but on the right 3, it is 81 on the boys choir, Now, since this is also a teaching video, I'm going to show you how and why I edited these the way I did. Okay, I'm back on Easy Swing where I started, and I am going to listen to their OTS settings here. Number 1 was a harmonica, and that was not in the album, so I changed that, of course, to what I did. Number 2 was perfect, so, but that one was on number 3, so I copied that to number 2. On their number 3, their OTS was perfect. Sounded just like the album, so I kept that there. Now, what was missing on OTS 4, I'm going to exit out, it was Keno strings again. Well, it didn't give me the sound I was looking at and looking for, because it didn't have Karen Carpenter's harmonics, vocal harmonics in it. So I changed OTS 3 here, and we're going to go back to my setting that I had just by pushing this thing right here. I went back and I chose the CFX concert cocktail grand and vibraphone, which I already stored in number 2, and I changed the OTS or the right 3 to those boys choir Now, there's going to be something important in the music when you're playing this, and that's going to be another trick that you're going to see. If I am playing the notes rather quickly, you're not going to hear that boys choir So I'm going to let you listen to that real quick. Thank you. you're only really hearing that choir really stick out when you're holding that note down or notes down. So it's really cool that you play the notes a little faster and you don't really hear the vocal harmony on there, but when you hold the note, you do. Now, one last thing on OTS setting 4, I'm going to zoom out here real quick. You can see that my harmony is on here. Now, not only is my harmony on, let's hit direct access and harmony arpeggiator or harmony echo on your Tyros. I have it on harmony and standard duet. However, go into your toolbar here and make sure your assign is on right 3, those choir voices, so you get the harmony where you want it. And that replicate Karen Carpenter's voice. It came out quite nicely. Now, the last thing that I did that's very, very important on here is I went to my rotary assignable button over here. I hit direct access and the rotary assign, and I made sure that I changed that to fade out from this organ rotary slow and fast. And that setting has to be in OTS 4 and also in your registration bank. So when you're setting up your harmony arpeggiator and you're setting up your assignable, it's only going to put the fade out on that one registration. So I placed that in number 4 so that it was there to fade the song out, which you're going to hear now that we're going to do the finished product. Okay, here's a close-up of the chords. We've got F major 7 to E7. E minor 7, hold all the notes down and drop that finger down to the A minor 7. Right there. Now, they're all the chords on the first page. There is a C major 7 to a C7. You hold all the notes down and just move one finger there. And after the E minor 7 on page 2, you've got A7. You've also got a G7 in there. And that's all the fingering that's on there, but that's all on the music for you. Okay, let's put on registration 6. That puts on my intro 2, variation A. Everything is ready to go. And please pay attention to when I jump in, because I'm going to be jumping in on my right hand before the intro is over to make it sound perfect. And there you go, using all the tools in your Genos to make this song sound terrific. Okay, on a personal note, I would like to thank all of you and give you many thanks and best wishes for the holiday season that's coming upon us here. And I wanted to let all of you know that when you do send emails, I do read them. I may not respond as much because I get so many emails and texts a week, but I do look at every email that comes in and read it and appreciate them. I hope you enjoyed this week's song, Close to You, as much as I did. Just love the Carpenters, and especially at Christmas time. Karen Carpenter, what such a pure voice. So until next time, and until I see you next week, and this is an early release for Black Friday, so you're not going to get it Friday, you're getting it now, so you're getting a twofer this week on Black Friday, and gives you some time to work on both songs over the nice long holiday weekend. So this is Mike Mixon from KeyboardAmerica.com and .co saying have a great day, keep playing, and here's Karen.
Why do birds suddenly appear every time you are near? Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do